including Jim Rouse, John Hamilton and Mark Prowse, along with the world supercarting champion Lennart Bolin of Sweden. The racing we're about to look at features carts from the 100cc and 125cc gearbox classes. We join commentator Tony Palmer now for Heat 1 of the supercarts.
Waiting now for a start in the first of the supercart races for 250cc machines. Most of them 6-speed, they're out on the circuit now. They will go around 2 or 3 laps until they form up in their grid order. When the starter is satisfied that they are in the right grid order, then he will give them a start. A mobile start, as always with kart races. Looking through the points situation as we start the first race. Leader at the moment is Paul Larson from England with 45 points. Lennart Bolin is in second place with 36. He's the world champion who had some problems at Ruapuna. And in third place is Mark Prowse from Auckland. Letter W there is Lennart Bolin. Number 21 is Paul Larson. Number one is Mark Prowse. These grids will be set up from the way they finished at Ruapuna. So basically the point situation will decide the grid order. And then as the day goes on, with three heats, each heat will decide its grid order from the previous one. Number 99 there is Jim Rouse, another leading competitor from the South Island. Mark Prowse number one, Jim Rouse. In Z is John Hamilton from Christchurch. He's fourth on the points table. Fourth equal, in fact, with Jim Rouse. Being told one more lap, weaving around, trying to get the tyres warm. They're running slicks, of course. The watch number 21, Paul Larson, the points leader. Lennart Bolin behind him, Mark Prowse. John Hamilton and Jim Rouse. Those are the men we would expect to be fighting it out in front. Not a very complicated course here on the streets of Christchurch. Two straights, essentially, joined by two hairpins on either side of Moorhouse Avenue. The orange flag comes down if they're set up in grid order for a start. When the orange flag drops, they're away. If he's not satisfied, they'll go around again. Okay, they're not giving him a start this time round. Being told to get into the right grid order. Next time round, perhaps. Sometimes they spend 5 or 6 laps before the starter is satisfied and drops the flag. Expect to start this time round. And watch those two at the front. Lennart Bolin, the world champion, letter W, and Paul Larson, number 21, who was leading the points table. Lennart Bolin, as we said, had some problems at Ruapuna. He had a couple of punctures and some fuel problems. He's changed the fuel pump from the pulse type to a cam-driven mechanical type. They're away. Jim Rouse getting excellent start right up the outside. John Hamilton in behind him, but Lennart Bolin leads to the first corner. Lennart Bolin round first. Jim Rouse going very wide. Paul Larson there. Mark Prowse up through. Mark Prowse got through on the first corner. Very, very well indeed. Bolin through that chicane like it wasn't even there. This is the world champion, Lennart Bolin from Sweden. Mark Prowse from New Zealand behind him. Third place, Jim Rouse. John Hamilton trying to take him on the outside. Mark Prowse through the corner. Somebody went wide there, I think. Jim Rouse has come through. It was John Hamilton who went too wide on the corner. So Jim Rouse up to third place. Mark Prowse in second. Lennart Bolin is the man they've got to catch. And Lee Paulin, I think, on his form at this early stage, he looks like he might be harder to catch today than he was at Ruapuna.
Very hard to catch. He wants to win this. It's a build-up to the world champs for him. He's all out to do it today.
Bear in mind that these drivers have to use the same tyres for all three races today. So you can't overdo it too much in the first race and blister them and ruin the tyre condition. That's Jim Rouse. Jim Rouse, who was fourth in the points table and third in the race, is pulled out. Any idea what the problem is?
On the chain, I think. By the look of the way the pair came off all of a sudden.
Lennart Bolin now coming up to laps of back markers. Number 15, Mark Childs there being lapped. This is the form of the world champion, Lennart Bolin. races has a shakedown for the World Championship this year. Having a look to see how far Mark Prowse is behind him. Twelve lap races, these. Here's the race leader, Leonard Bolland. He really gets through that chicane like it wasn't there.
Yeah, he's got the circuit sussed out very quickly, and of course I think from all his experience overseas, it doesn't take him very long to lay sights on a new circuit like this. It's going to be very hard to beat.
He doesn't race all that often on street circuits, but like everybody else, you've got to learn it.
Street circuits don't really exist in Europe and on the continent. And it just shows a class of a guy like this. He's got a tremendous amount of skill, obviously. I don't think we'll see him make a mistake today. He made a mistake at Ruapuna and spun going into the hairpin. He was very disappointed. And I was talking to him before the races, and he said he won't do that again.
An incredibly, intensely competitive man is Leonard Bolland. Give you some idea of speeds. These little machines are capable of 150 miles an hour. They won't be doing that on this little street circuit because they're geared down a little to get the power out of corners, but still well over 100 miles an hour. That's Leonard Bolland. Let's have a look back and see how far Mark Prowse is behind him. There's the gap back to Prowse. Leonard Bolland being slow, just a little getting through that chicane by a back marker. Mark Prowse through on him, making up just a little, but now he has the back marker. Hopefully he'll get him in a straight line. The familiar sideways motion of Mark Prowse, who has always preferred to drive that way instead of straight lines, which is the current fashion. The name Crosby on the back of Mark Prowse's leathers. He borrowed Graham Crosby's leathers for the series. A little confusing with the names, but it is definitely Mark Prowse, the top New Zealander in there, in second place behind Leonard Bolland of Sweden. On the ninth lap of 12 now, another two before the white flag comes out for the penultimate lap. Leonard Bolland really only needs to stay in front and do what he's doing. He wants a perfect record today. Mark Prowse is certainly going to keep him honest. And there again, Leonard Bolland, given the white flag this time. Slowed just a little by some backmarkers, but Mark Prowse is having to come through the same traffic, just slightly behind Leonard Bolland. Often it can be a real advantage to put a backmarker between you and the second place. Neither Mark Prowse nor Leonard Bolland has had any real advantage from the traffic. Checkered flag coming out. But Leonard Bolland, sweep, a very happy man indeed. Leonard Bolland first, Mark Prowse second. And looking back for third place, John Hamilton, is it?
John Hamilton it was, yeah. It's a fair way back, huh?
So really, Mark Prowse, the only one putting any pressure on Leonard Bolland. The world champion who really needs the points today to win this series. He was very, very conscious of the fact that he had made the odd mistake and had some problems at Ruapuna. Very fired up when we spoke to him earlier on in the pits and absolutely determined to take it out today. So Leonard Bolland wins the first one from Mark Prowse, and in third place, another New Zealander, John Hamilton. No start this time round for the supercarts in Heat 2. Form up next time round on the grid. Mark Prowse number one, Leonard Bolland letter W, New Zealand's John Hamilton with NZ. Number five is Robin Herron. Number 21, Paul Larson back out there. He had a gearbox problem in the first race, so he had a DNF. And Jim Rouse had a clutch problem in the first race and also had a DNF. So Leonard Bolland on his way, if he can continue this form, to winning the series overall. He needed points at this meeting. He finished in second place with 36 after the Ruapuna, behind Paul Larson. With Paul Larson having had a DNF in the first heat today, it means that Leonard Bolland can win the series, but he's got to win three races, or at least keep Paul Larson back behind second place. They've got a start this time round. Mark Prowse, an excellent start. Racing up to the first corner. Bolan on the inside. Prowse on the outside. Bolan pushes him out. Leonard Bolan going quite wide. Prowse on the outside of him. Hamilton couldn't get through there. In third place now. Bolan, Prowse, Hamilton. Mark Prowse really pushing Leonard Bolan this time. Bolan got away with the two there. Derek Wilson spinning. Bolan got away with a little bit of a lead in the first heat and managed to sneak away from Mark Prowse. Mark Prowse was telling us earlier on that one of the problems with his kart is that he can't slipstream. Other karts can slipstream behind him, but he can't make his slipstream. Trying to get close enough there to Leonard Bolan to get a draft, but he said it doesn't work particularly well because of where he's got his wing, I think. 12 laps again this race. Mark Prowse, you'll notice, takes slightly different lines than Leonard Bolan. Much more sideways movement in the kart. Leonard Bolan driving a little straighter in his lines. Through the chicane that time. It all happens so quickly in these little supercarts. 125 odd miles an hour in the straight line. Mark Prowse just starting to lose a gap there a little bit. Have a look as they come up under brakes. Mark Prowse is driving a different style for a couple of reasons than the world champion Leonard Bolan. One is that he likes to take wider lines and go sideways. The other is that he has an artificial limb. He only has one leg, so he can only use one foot for both pedals, which means that you can't use the brake and the accelerator at the same time. You've got to use one or the other in his case. Mark Prowse seems to be the only one chasing Leonard Bolan here, Lee.
Yeah, he's definitely the only one that's in the hunt, I think. And he's doing a tremendous job. As you said before, he has a problem slipstreaming. And that's not being of any effect, of any help to him at all. So what he's doing out there is tremendous. And he's obviously really keyed up and wound up. And it's unfortunate that one of the other New Zealand drivers, the New Zealand Supercar champion John Hamilton there is unable to make any progress because he's leaving it all up to Mark to try and put the pressure on Leonard Bolan. I feel he just can't quite get close enough to outbreak him.
The finish order in the first heat was Bolan, Prowse, Hamilton. That's the order in the second heat. At the end of four laps, Hamilton starting to drop back a little on Mark Prowse in second place. The gap between Bolan and Prowse has stayed about the same. Prowse just starting to lose a snippet now to Leonard Bolan. But John Hamilton dropping back quite a ways in third place. Number 23, Kevin Grenfell from New Zealand, is in fourth place. Bolan through the chicane, Prowse through the chicane. Have a look at the gap between those two. Bolan into the straight again. NW, Leonard Bolan, number one, Mark Prowse. Behind them is Robin Herron. There's John Hamilton in third place. Herron has been lapped. And Mark Childs in fourth place. But John Hamilton really just not able to keep in touch with these front two at all. Mark Prowse got an excellent start. It looked as though he might get to the first corner on the inside line, but Leonard Bolan beat him to it. This is the winning style of the current world champion, Leonard Bolan. Racing in New Zealand in his off-season to keep race fit and perhaps to progress a little bit with the development of the Rotax 250 engine, which is the popular choice of all the top kart races in 250 class now. TZ Yamahas used to be as fast, but the application to karts seems to favour the Rotax. It has more low-down power, seems to get torque better, and the initial drive out of corners. The TZ Yamaha motor still the quicker on the two in cycle racing, motorcycle racing. But for the kart application, the Rotax is really very, very hard to beat. Leonard Bolan starting to pull away just a little now. That's the white flag for Leonard Bolan this time round. On the last lap, he won the first heat. He looks like winning the second. Mark Prowse, not all that far behind him, but losing just a little in the last couple of laps. So bowling round this time. Checkered flag on this last lap. Leonard Boland, the world champion, wins the second. Two starts, two wins. Mark Prowse of New Zealand second. John Hamilton of New Zealand third. And Lee, it's hard to see him being beaten in the third. He's obviously got the bit between his teeth and going for it today.
Yeah, he's going for it. Mechanical problems are the only thing that'll upset his day. And I would imagine he's brought his own mechanic out from Sweden with him. And I don't think he'll have too many mechanical problems.
So we'd have to pick Leonard Boland to make it 3 out of 3 today on current form. New Zealand's Mark Prowse is about the only competitor really keeping him honest. John Hamilton not able to stay on that very quick pace in the front. And it might come down to the start in the third and last heat. But Leonard Boland looks for all the world like he's going to take the Trans Zealand Cup. Let's see if Ian Love, the race starter, drops the yellow flag for a start this time round in the third heat. 100cc stock Yamaha class. He's dropped the flag. They're away. Murray Davies on the inside in the lie-down cart. He's the man that leads the series and won the first heat. Number 28, Jeff Bone, first to the first corner. Behind him comes Nigel Wilkinson, number 65. Murray Davies dropping back just a little bit. Let's see how long it takes him to get up to the front. Already up to second place. No, third place. Still Nigel Wilkinson holding second. And Murray Davies, if we get a chance to see him in the lead in this lie-down car, in third place there at the moment. He has something of a handling problem with it. They're not as easy to drive as the sit-up carts. Obviously, the handling problem has made itself worse in the last couple of seconds going right around there.
He's lost it completely. He did everything he possibly could to keep it under control, but they're so hard to get around corners because they're so long, he just couldn't keep it in.
I noticed that his turn-ins were all right, but the exits to corners, very untidy.
He's really got to work and really concentrate. You'll notice him, Roger Middlebrook trying to make a big break on the brake. Is it? No, it's not. It's Nigel Wilkinson. But he can't, he's not going to pull it off. He's going to hang back.
Jeff Bone still leading. He finished second in the second heat. He was the only one really pushing Murray Davies. Now it's left to Jeff Bone with Nigel Wilkinson pushing him hard. Number 37, there's Grant Clearwater, who was fourth at the start of the day on the points table. He's putting his hand down to touch the carburetor there. You can explain that a little, Lee.
Yeah, what they're trying to do there is that they're obviously trying to lean the high speed of the carburetor out just to get a little bit more top line speed. Very dangerous manoeuvre. It's likely to seize engines, but he considers that it's worth blowing his engine up to win this. And it looks like he's pulling alongside Jeff Bone up on there. Bone's going to have to duck in behind as they come through the chicane. And Grant Clearwater's tucked himself into second. But there's Murray Davies in the hay bales again. He's still got the motor running, so he's going to get away. Murray's definitely having handling problems.
Did well to keep the motor running and to keep in, but really out of contention totally. 65, Nigel Wilkinson leading from 37, Grant Clearwater, and Jeff Bone back in third place. 23, Roger Middlebrook keeping him honest in fourth place, the man from Nelson. But it's Nigel Wilkinson holding out the lead from Grant Clearwater.
Nigel Wilkinson, he's driving superbly. He's only 16 years old, this boy. He could have just turned 17. And he's tucking his head down behind the steering wheel going for the doctor. And he's really
good. Grant Clearwater behind him, but can't really make any impression on him. This youngster, Nigel Wilkinson, pulling away. Hard to see from that camera angle, but Nigel Wilkinson has quite a substantial lead, as you see, when you see it side on. He's really getting away from this bunch of three behind him, who are perhaps holding each other up with the dicing. Grant Clearwater, Roger Middlebrook, Jeff Bone. Far away now from a start in the third and final supercart race in the Trans Zealand series, the second meeting. Leonard Boland came out of the first meeting having had some mechanical problems, in second place on the points overall behind Paul Larson. Paul Larson's chances of winning the championship went down the drain when he had a DNF in the first heat and didn't start in the second. He is out for the third as well, so now the championship comes down to Leonard Boland winning this race. And I think the first New Zealander in second place overall will be Mark Prowse. And those of us who've seen him drive on the streets before know that Mark Prowse is a quick driver on the roads, but I'm sure he surprised a lot of people here today.
Well, especially with South Islanders, Tony. It's nice to see Mark go so well. And we haven't seen a great deal of him down here. And we've only been told that he's good stuff to watch on the road, and he definitely is. It makes the hairs on the back of your neck stand up when you see this guy. He's competing against the world champion, and supercarting is huge overseas. And this guy's got everything, and Mark deserves a medal for this.
It's really surprising in today's day and age, in all forms of four-wheeled motorsport, the sideways movement has really been eliminated almost, and straight lines are said to be the quickest way. I know Mark Prowse still prefers to drive sideways, and he doesn't seem to lose a great deal by it.
No, I don't think he'll ever let his secret out either. They can't go sideways today because of the tyres, and once you're going sideways, you're not going forwards, and so you must lose time. And the tyres stick onto the road so well that you're likely to stick yourself on your helmet. But Mark's just got some uncanny knack, and nobody else in New Zealand, or I think in the world, can probably do it as well as this guy does. I don't think we'll ever know his secret.
When you consider that he drives with one leg because he has an artificial limb, they're away in this third race. He does exceptionally well because he must use the same foot for the brake and for the gas pedal.
Yeah, he's having a little bit of problem here as he's drifted right back to fifth of Boland, and Hamilton come through on the outside of Mark Jones on the outside of him on third. And there's John Hamilton taking out the hay bale with Boland and behind him. Number 10 gets away again. But it was definitely Leonard Boland who streams into the first hairpin. Mark Childs is second, is another problem. But Boland, with W on the front there, is way out in front and not being challenged at this stage.
Well, that may be the story of the day for Leonard Boland. The yellow flags are out so that John Hamilton and Mark Prowse can catch up. Leonard Boland slows down a little under the yellows, but he got a superb start and managed to evade the incidents that happened there on the first couple of corners. So Leonard Boland really away with an excellent position in the third and final, and a very, very good chance at this stage of taking out the series overall. His major opposition in Paul Larson has been eliminated. John Hamilton looks like he might not have a restart. And Mark Prowse is the man to watch now to come up to second place. Jimmy Rouse in third place. Number 23 there, Kevin Grenfell in second place. Jim Rouse from Christchurch challenging him and up into second place. So Leonard Boland from Jim Rouse, from Kevin Grenfell, and Mark Prowse dropping back just a little.
Jimmy Rouse seems to have a handling problems here. He appears to have some oversteer coming into the corner, and on these street circuits you just can't have oversteer. But Boland's definitely out in front. Rouse has got his hand up and pulling out number 99. Got mechanical problem or something. So that puts 23, Kevin Grenfell, back in the second slot.
Well, the attrition rate here is enormous. Half of the field is lost already. Leonard Boland gaining great advantage. He's got less traffic to drive through. He got a superb start, and he's away. They won't get near him. Leonard Boland looks like taking out the championship overall, barring mechanical failure or making a silly mistake, which he's not really in a position to be likely to do. Number 23 there, Kevin Grenfell, still in second place, but a long way back.
Yeah, Boland getting signs there from his pit crew just to let him know that he's a long way out in front. Back off the power of Weaver, because there's no need for Leonard to go all out now. So I'd like to know where Mark Prowse has got to. We must have lost him, I think, Tony.
Yes, I was just looking back on the last lap to see where Mark Prowse was. He was picking up speed and he's got a problem of some kind with the car.
Definitely has.
I wonder if some of the sideways movement hasn't ruined the edge on his tyres. They've got to use the same tyres for all three races today. That was something a lot of them were talking about earlier in the pits. You can't go out too fast or too hard in the first couple, or the tyres will be off for the third race.
Yeah, I think Mark's definitely got a problem, and it could be tyres. You can see he's got a fair handful in his hands. It's not that bumpy, and it appears to be with Mark. He's definitely got some problem.
No, he's really getting off fine.
Yeah, it could be.
Looks to me as if the tyres have gone off. Whichever way it is, Leonard Molden is a mile out in front and has this championship sewn up. Just deserts for him in the sense that he had problems in Ruapuna which were beyond his control. Only one of them, a mistake he made, and got into a spin at the hairpin. Otherwise, it was stuff that he couldn't control. And so it's perhaps nice to see the world champion back in winning style in three races today.
He's going to be pleased that it's come together for him here on Moorhouse Avenue, because he's using this for a build-up to the World Championships, which they take place at Le Mans, which is the racing circuit that we all know of, and then into Germany to Nuremberg, and then to Silverstone in England. And Lennon said that this was going to be used as a build-up for the World Champs. At number five, Robin Heron being lapped by Lennon in the ex-Steve Jones supercar.
And perhaps following around for a couple of laps to learn some clever lines.
I think a lot of these guys really welcome the chance to get behind a guy like Lennon Bolton, because it's the only chance they really get to know what it's about overseas.
But he is not in second place as it appears on the screen. He is a lap down. Lennon Bolton, the leader by a substantial margin. Still, we think Kevin Grenfell in second place. That's the white flag this time round for Lennon Bolton on his last lap.
Well, you can see Robin Heron's trying everything possible, although Leonard Bolden slowed down a wee bit, he's trying everything possible to stay with him, and it's a good experience for him.
An excellent education to follow the world champion for a lap or two, despite being a lap down. Stay with him on a slightly slower pace and you'll still learn some lines. Obviously Leonard Bolden gets out of the corners a little better. The checkered flag for Leonard Bolden.
He's delighted, look at that. Yeah. He said it's all worth it.
Now Robin Heron in second place, as it appeared, is a lap down, as we said. Looking back for second place, we think it will still be Kevin Grenfell, number 23, the New Zealander. But really, the places are incidental, because the overall winner of the series is Leonard Bolden. He came here and was looking a little tense and certainly very, very determined in the pits this morning. And when we asked him if he thought he might take it easy and look for places in the first one and win the last, he said he wanted to win all three, despite the fact that you have to use the same tyres. He has driven superbly from the front of the field. He has never really been challenged. He's only been kept honest by Mark Prowse in the first two races. In the third, the one we've just seen, the attrition rate was so high that Leonard Bolden was never really challenged. And he has taken out the series overall. A very happy little Swede, Leonard Bolden. And confirmation of the fact that the world champion, Leonard Bolden of Sweden, has cleaned up the overall situation, the meeting both Ruapuna and on the streets of Christchurch here. He finishes with 81 points and a perfect record today. Mark Prowse keeps New Zealand's flag high. The Aucklander has finished second overall with 60 points. Kevin Grenfell in another Rotax, 48 points. Obviously, the Rotax machines are the ones to beat. The first six places taken up by them. New Zealand's John Hamilton, 47 points in fourth place. Then Paul Larson and Robin Heron. And Paul Larson, despite finishing on the same points as Robin Heron, would win overall because he has finished in more first places.